Bow to beginner students. Welcome.
And, you know, in these times, I'm not sure what part of like introductory talks, I have a million of them, I'm not sure who's heard what. So the salute that we do, the right hand goes into a fist, which symbolizes strength or power. The left covers it, which symbolizes softness or self-control. And then we just do the bow, and that's sort of our sign of respect for our fellow students or teachers. Whatever. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Cool, sir. All right. Let's do a little deep breath and relaxation to begin. The eyes close and soften both. You can allow the lips to be lightly sealed and the teeth gently meshed together. And if you like, you can take the tip of the tongue and place it against the roof of the mouth behind the front teeth. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out through the nose as well. When you breathe in, feel your lower abdomen expand outwards a little. Breathe out, feel it go back in. Imagine the cascade of relaxation flowing down the body. Feel it start right at the top of the head. Move downward, the face relaxed. See if you can feel around the rest of the scalp relax. The jaw, the eyes soften a little more, the brow soften. Relax the neck. Feel the upper back and chest relax. Feel the relaxation spread to the shoulders, arms, and hands. Relax the stomach. Let go of tension from the lower back. Relax the waist, the hips. Relax thighs and backs of the legs. Feel the knees soften. Allow the relaxation to continue through the calves, the ankles, the feet. There's a saying in Tai Chi called saying something like, let the whole body be one. You want to hear that is let the whole body be one breath. You can hear that. And one way to sort of translate that would be to think of the whole body being involved in each breath. We're feeling the breath throughout the body. For now, release, lower the hands, open the eyes. Separate the feet to a shoulder width. Let's do a good 3 minutes of embracing for us today. Sink down, round out. And the body is rounded in a couple ways, like in the chest and arms. If you looked from above, you would want a circle there, even though the elbows and shoulders should relax down. And then the legs with the knees rounded out, feeling a little rounded out there, like horseback riding. about 2.5 more minutes. Go ahead and, as you hold, focus on the breath. More seconds. Release, straighten the legs, lower the hands. Breathe in, circle the arms up. Breathe out, push palms down. Okay. When you first learn Tai Chi, yes, it's very important to focus on all the details of very specifically where the feet and the hands are, and there's a lot to memorize. And that's part of the fun puzzle, depending on how your personality is. I enjoyed that part of it. But it's not too early to start thinking about how to move in those postures. And one sort of guideline from the beginning is softer than you think, slower than you think, relaxed in that calm, alert way. Right? So just something to keep in mind as we're moving through the moves we've already covered. Already, I bet at some point you have some moves that are less thought intensive, right? They're already habituated into the body and mind a little more. And some that are like, I'm going to need a little time on this one, right? That's normal. Any questions? Okay. Pull back and press.
Pull back and press.
Press.
Good. single width.
Single width.
Lift hands.
Lift hands.
Strike the shoulder.
Strike the shoulder.
White crane spreads wings.
White crane spreads wings.
Brush knee push one.
Brush knee push one.
Playing guitar one.
Playing guitar one.
Brush knee push two.
Brush knee push two.
Brush knee push three.
Brush knee push three.
Brush knee push four.
Brush knee push four.
Playing guitar two.
Playing guitar two.
Brush knee push five.
Brush knee push five.
All right, and we did preview the next, but let's not touch it quite yet. Who could do all that without copying? Just curious. No expectation.
What did you say?
Who could do all that without copying?
Oh.
Just curious. Just information gathering.
Yeah.
No grades. I'm going to make you all compete against each other. How about that? No, let's work together. Okay. All right, does anyone want to see any part of that again, just for their curiosity or filling in some blank along the way?
Could you do lift hands?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. If you want to come check it out from whatever angle. And you'll hear me say a lot. Make sure you have a good starting position. If I'm slightly off, then I can do it right, but it won't be correct. Does that answer your question, or do you have more of a question?
I guess I'm wondering the difference or the similarity between lift hands and playing guitar.
Good question. This is very common, or often people have this question. So the best answer I have is, in their final position, they're just opposite sides facing opposite directions. So then why are they called different names, right? One is because when these forms were put together, there were no left-handed people in China, so the guitar would be right-handed. Right. I say that kind of jokingly, but yeah, that's kind of how it came about. And then also, it's what you're doing in the move, not just the final position. So in lift hands, I'm actually coming up and forward, whereas in playing guitar, I'm coming out and back in.
Yes,
so it kind of, does that make sense?
Yes, yeah. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, you're very welcome. Anyone else want to see anything or have any other questions? Very good. Okay, let's get right into the hidden hand punch and see how that shakes out. So let's start from a good brush knee push five. And again, if you want to just move at any time, yeah, it feels like a front and a back when I'm bowing in, but after that, be wherever you need to be to observe. Yeah. And we can change spots as necessary. Okay, let's step through it. First, shift back, make a fist in the right hand, slightly lean forward. Turn to the left, put it on the heel. Good. Shift to the left, release the right heel. Stay low or sink down, step in, step out to a T. So now I want the toes to point out rather than pointing forward. And if you want to check it, you can slide it back. Just bear in mind that when you look down, your center changes. Sorry. Shift to the right, look to the left, lift the hands also into a T. And the left palm will face out, the right fist, the palm of the right fist will face in. Good. Turn to the right, release the left heel. Step in with the left. Step out, go for double dragon split placement if you know what that means. Shift forward and basically turn to the front to punch under the hand. And at the end, the left hand will just be above the elbow, palm in, kind of like half an embracing force almost. And the right hand, yeah. And we talked about the knuckles being stacked.
Yeah, cool. Okay,
release. Does that make sense? Stacked.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it was stacked instead of bent. Okay, cool. Do it a couple more times.
Yes, sir.
Start to get familiar with it. First, shift back. Make your fist in your right hand, lean forward. We talked about that tendency to lean back in a lot of moves, and here's a chance to directly not do that. Turn to the left foot on the heel. Shift to the left, release the right heel. All good, step in. Step out to your feet. Shift to the right, turn to the left, lift the hands. Make your T there, good. Turn to the right, release the left heel. Step in, step out, heel come. Shift forward, turn forward. Kind of a slight turn to the left, but you're turning left to your center. Okay, one more time.
Yes, sir.
Begin, go back. Turn to the left. Shift to the left. Release the right. Step to your T. Shift to the right. Turn to the left. Lift the hand. Make a T. Turn to the right, release the left, heel, step, dragons, shift, turn. Release. You want to do that one more time, or are you ready to see it from the front?
One more time.
Yeah, cool. So I have a feeling, sometimes there's that one more time feeling in the room. If your arm's all the way straight, keep a little bend in the elbow. These sleeves don't show it, but it's still rounded, connected. Shift back, make the fist lean forward. Turn to the heel. Shift to the right, release the left. Step in, step to your feet. Shift to the right, turn to the left with the hands. Turn to the right, release the left. Step. Step test, think about it. Shift, turn. All right. Oh, you're very welcome. Why don't y'all check it out from the front-ish? And, when you see from the other side, you want to basically get whatever visually you couldn't see before, but also having it kind of come at you can be beneficial, just because it's weird. Our body and mind, the whole system, sort of intuits something that's like an attack, or seeing it coming at you can just change it. I don't know why. Take it more seriously. Remember, we're breaking down something that will not be so broken down eventually. Suggestions. Yes, sir.
Yes, the arm placement on the first one, it looks like the other arm here. I seem to be kind of doing this, I guess. I feel like I'm doing something wrong here. From what I just saw from you, it's a little further back.
Maybe. So I'll probably have a better sense when I see you do it again, now that I'm looking for that in you particularly. But one thing it may be is if I go here and just put the arms there is one thing. But if I shift my weight and turn the body to get the arms there,
okay.
Is that maybe? I don't know if that's what you're talking about.
Yeah, I'm just on the move, but I was just curious about that arm placement.
Is this what you are seeing or doing? Or?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know if I'm doing that or not.
Okay.
It's all right. Yeah, just a touch confused with that.
It's,
I think for me, it's more like I wind up like that, as opposed to you're more vertical.
Mm, okay, very good.
I guess he's right, too. Yeah, I feel like I'm leaning.
Yeah, okay.
And there's a little of that, so maybe it's just a matter of degree. But yeah, when I'm shifting and turning to the right, yeah, I don't wanna come over too far. It's still got that idea of like the head suspended at the top of it. Does that make sense? Yes, sir.
And maybe I've just overlooked it, but I believe this is the first time we've ever had a shift to one leg and a turn in the other direction together. Because you shift right and then you turn left, and that seems different from what we've done before on so many different movements. There may be another, but I don't remember it.
Because it seems like usually you're shifting and then turning that same leg.
Yes, right.
Yeah, that's an interesting point. It's a little funky in single width, right? But yeah, it is a different feeling kind of move, I would say, compared to a lot of the ones we've done so far. Good. We're good. Any other questions, or does that answer your just kind of observation? Any other questions?
Right before you do the punch, your left hand, is it more of like in a relaxed prayer position rather than a rounded?
Yes. Okay. And learning this application will tell you a lot about that hand. Basically, the idea is some sort of attack is coming in, and I'm deflecting it downward with my right arm, and then I'm checking elbow with my left. And then I'm actually going to punch under the ribs. And it's called hidden hand punch because as the attacker, you actually won't see it. It'll come in and you won't see it coming. And, you know, like, that's the worst hit, just the kind that you don't see it coming, or it's a surprise. Our body subconsciously will brace or sort of take, you know, find a way to take it if we know it's coming. But does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, cool. So arms that kind of come down together, and yeah, it's not going to be so much around your neck. It's like, imagine just pointing someone's elbow, right? Just touching, and you're not pushing on it, but you feel that elbow there in case they move. Punch on it. Good. Cool. Any others? Should we practice a little bit?
Yes.
All right, let's practice it. Come on out. And we'll do some stopping at all these sort of midpoints to make sure, like that T with the arms is always tricky to get the feel for it. Okay, reset. And if anyone wants to come closer, that's fine too. If you're feeling crowded. Okay, still with some instruction for now. Shift back, knee forward, make the fist in the right. Turn, pivot on the hip. Shift to the left, release the right. Step in. Step to your T. Shift to the right, turn to the left. Turn the right, release the left heel. Oh, I said we were going to stop, but I didn't. We'll go next time. And then shift forward. And reset.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Go ahead and give me your brush knee. We'll do a little brush knee check. So shift back, lean forward, make the fist, and just hang out there. So see if you can feel a balance between your sitting back and leaning forward. It might feel a little guitarish, but not such an extreme. But okay, turn to the left, pivot on the hip. Shift to the right, release the left. Step in. Step to the T. Shift to the right, turn to the left, lift the hands into a T, and hold there. Okay, turn to the right, release the left heel. Yeah, and then when you do that, both arms will sort of, it'll feel like both of them are sort of pulling to your right, and it almost might feel like you're drawing back on a bow with your right. and feel the tension between that drawing back and stepping in, and your balance stepping out. And shift. See if you can feel a little of that right hip connect to your punch as it turns in. Okay, release. Shake it out a little. You know, talking about turning and shifting, this posture does have this kind of thing where, you know, we kind of wind up one way, and then we wind up the other way, and then we come forward. So turning left to go right, turning right to go left to go back to side. Okay, let's try it again.
Sure.
And begin. Shift. Turn. Shift. Release. Step. Step to the T. Shift. Turn. Lift to the T. Good. Turn. Heel releases as you turn away. Step. Shift. Turn. Punch. One, two, three. Shift. Turn. Punch. Reset. About two more for now. Begin back. Pivot. Shift. Release. Step. T. Shift. Turn. Turn. Release. Step. Out. Shift. Turn. Punch. One more. Find your starting position and then grow. And just go and copy Mr. Barry if you need to. I'll kind of talk you through it one more time. Shift back. Turn to the left. Shift. Release the heel. Step to the T. Shift. Turn to the left. Yeah, turn to the right. Release the left. Step. And step to out, shift, punch, release, shift. Okay, very good. I like what I saw. That was very attentive understanding of all the different frames to get there. Any other questions on it for the moment? Cool. Watch one more time. So, yeah, watch it one more time. I want to show you a little different take on it. There's going to be some little things different in what you see now. I just want to show you more quickly what's actually going to happen when we can get it smoothed out. Okay. So that's sort of where we're headed with this. So, yes, do this for now, but it's something that will sort of fall away and be implied in the motion of what really happens in this move, which is I'm just going to deflect the punch. Any questions about that? Okay.
I had to remind myself that you weren't teaching me something new, you were just slowing it down. It's like, oh, yeah.
right, yeah. Step forward, deflect downward, intercept. Punch. That's the fun bit. But we'll call it hidden hand, punch it out, just for brevity. let's see, what else to say? Oh, yeah, while you're watching. From here, we've got withdraw and push, cross hands, feet together. And that's the end of the section that we cover in this unit. So if you feel like, when's it ever end? Well, we're very close. We're very close to that. And if you're like, when will it ever end? Pretty soon you'll be like, that's it? That's all we got? Where's the rest of it? It's short. It seems shorter than what you're used to. All right. Let's come on out and let's go from the top one more time.
Yes, sir.
And don't even worry about calling back this time. Just breathe, relax, move as best you can. And begin. Thank you.
Strike the shoulder smoothly into right brain spreads wings. Brush knee push, the first one. Playing guitar, first one. Brushing, push two, three, and four. Brush knee in this section. See people connected in a hand punch. Very good. All right. Any last questions, comments, or suggestions? Oh, yeah. So, yeah, yes class Tuesday, no class Thursday. And also, if you come Monday, Wednesday, yes class Monday, no class Wednesday. Follow the five hearts, faith, respect, perseverance, patience, humility.
Oh, sorry.
It's all right.
About our senior head instructor.
Thank you, sir. Bow to advanced and beginner students. Basic training dismissed. Very good.